Welcome back. In the previous video, we clarified the concept of management information systems as opposed to mere computer tools and information and communication technologies. We also anticipated that in this video, we would discuss their importance and therefore how can a better understanding of management information systems be of use for you. I therefore have to follow up on the question posed in the previous video on why did you join this course? Having sorted out what management information systems are, what do you expect to get out of this course and how will it be useful for you? After all, chances are that you are not a management information systems professional, and hopefully you do not count on becoming one by taking this introductory course.
Oh really? So, after all the hype surrounding this course, are you telling me now that, after completing it, I would not be recognized as an expert in the field?
Well, not quite. I'm afraid that information systems is a quite broad area of knowledge and becoming an expert would take a bit longer than following a MOOC. The good news, however, are that you don't need to become an expert in order to benefit from understanding management information systems better. As an illustration, nearly all business academic programs, as well as countless programs in other non-ICT areas, include introductory management information system courses. This suggests that there is a widespread agreement on the perceived value of some familiarity with these systems. While recruiting candidates from many different backgrounds for a variety of positions, management information systems exposure is one of the most generally sought after general skills, along with foreign languages. Several factors can help to explain the perceived usefulness of management information systems awareness, such as ubiquity. Nowadays, information systems are used for nearly every task conducted in companies. Cross-functionality. Management information systems lie at the frontier between information and communication technologies and business. Thus, discussions and decisions on management information systems generally require inputs from various viewpoints, rather than merely the perspective of management information systems specialists. This leads to inclusiveness. Over your professional life, you will most likely be involved in management information system projects. If not as a developer, as a user, a tester, or a functional support. Their role as enablers. Management information systems enable or make feasible or sensible new ways of doing things, and sometimes even doing new things. Familiarity with the potential and shortcomings of information systems is thus useful regardless of your specific area of specialization. However, the key reason for the importance generally attributed to a well-grounded understanding of management information systems is their ever-growing role in the day-to-day business life of a large percentage of the employees as orchestra directors. Or, if you want to be less politically correct, as policemen or transmission chains. A growing share of the workforce uses one or several management information systems as the key means to carry out their tasks, and spend a sizable chunk of their working day in front of the screens. Among many of their remaining employees, their work is tightly controlled and governed by management information systems, which in this case ensure that work is carried out in the manner approved by the management. Thus the policeman or transmission chain nicknames. If all these employees whose working life is so closely intertwined with the management information systems do not have a broad understanding of what management information systems are, why do they impose the annoying restrictions that they actually do impose, and how and under which circumstances can they be modified, these employees are likely to be frustrated and to be way less effective than their potential. This is compounded by the increasing complexity of management information systems. Management information systems are becoming more integrated, both within each company and across its boundaries. Besides, the trend towards distributed systems, delocalization, virtualization, and globalization can easily confound employees that end up not understanding which system they are using. Thus, to recap, in contrast with flying aeroplanes, since some basic notions on how to fly a plane are unlikely to be useful unless you're actually proficient enough to pilot one, acquiring a solid but basic understanding of management information systems is likely to be a good investment. It will boost your employability in a wide range of positions, and it might help you to better understand what is going on around you in your workplace, and thus make you more effective and improve your satisfaction at the same time. Let us now have a look in the next videos at how management information systems are procured or developed, after posing a few review questions. Thank you. I will see you there.